The Staten Island Peace Conference was a brief meeting, held in the hope of bringing an end to the American Revolutionary War. The conference took place on September 11, 1776, at Billop Manor, the residence of Colonel Christopher Billop, on Staten Island, New York. The participants were the British Admiral Lord Richard Howe, and members of the Second Continental Congress John Adams, Benjamin Franklin, and Edward Rutledge. Since Lord Howe's authority was, by design, extremely limited, the congressional delegation was pessimistic about the meeting's outcome. The conference, held in the days after the British capture of Long Island, lasted just 3 hours, and was a failure. The Americans insisted on recognition of their recently declared independence, and Howe's limited authority was inadequate to deal with that development. After the conference, the British continued their military campaign for control of New York City. Effects: the congressmen returned to Philadelphia, and reported that Lord Howe has no propositions to make us, and that America is to expect nothing but total unconditional submission. 21 John Adams learned many years later that his name was on a list of people specifically excluded from any pardon offers the House might make. 22 Congress published the committee's report without comment. Because Lord Howe did not also publish an account of the meeting, the meeting's outcome was perceived by many as a sign of British weakness. However, many loyalists and some British observers suspected the congressional report misrepresented the meeting. 23 One British commentator wrote of the meeting, "They met, they talked, they parted. And now nothing remains but to fight it out." 20 Lord Howe reported the failure of the conference to his brother, and they then made preparations to continue the campaign for New York City. 24 4 days after the conference, British troops landed on Manhattan and occupied New York City. 25 Parliamentary debate over the terms of the diplomatic mission and its actions prompted some opposition Whig members to essentially boycott parliamentary proceedings. 3 The next major peace effort occurred in 1778, when the British sent commissioners led by the Earl of Carlisle to occupied Philadelphia. They were authorized to treat with Congress as a body, and offered self-government that was roughly equivalent to dominion status. This effort was undermined by the planned withdrawal of British troops from Philadelphia, and by American demands that the commissioners were not authorized to grant. 26 The house where the conference took place is now preserved as a museum within Conference House Park, a city park. 27 It is a National Historic Landmark, and is listed on the National Register of Historic Places.